Good evening, everybody. Welcome to day three of this program. I sincerely appreciate you all for coming. Welcome, class. Yesterday, we had a class, and that was probably on day two. Day two's class was wow, was wonderful. In fact, we were able to cover a whole lot of things. And today, day three's class would be more or less like a practical class. I repeat. The three's class would be more or less like a practical class. Like I said previously, you can start from this training in Forex and you can grow from zero to hero if you are consistent with this training. For those that have not been consistent, what happened? I have a YouTube link. I have been dropping those links for them to watch. Are you with me? I've been doing that for everybody to watch. So today is day three. For those in the house, have you been able to download MetaTrader 4? You set it up and all of that, because I gave some instructions. I dropped some instructions to you on the WhatsApp group. Yes, Mr. Mark, are you able to do that?
Yeah, I've done it.
Oh,
I
won't
have, yeah.
You have it before, right?
Yeah, I have it before.
Okay, all right. We'll be doing some things today. So let me start quickly, please. Yes, sir. Let me start immediately. What do we have for day three? For day three, we'll just give some theoretical analysis of MetaTrader 4 and 5, and quickly we leave. We give a quick analysis of MetaTrader 4 and 5. Now, Meta 4 is an electronic trading platform widely used by online retail foreign exchange speculative traders. It was actually developed in 2005. And it is licensed to foreign exchange brokers who provide the software to their clients. Now, this software can consist of both a client and a server component. The server component is run by the brokers, and the client software is provided to the broker's customers. Who are the broker's customers? You and I. Who are the brokers? OctForex, OctaFX, Antec. So on and so forth. Later, MetaTrader 5 was released, but this showed up in 2013. This showed up in 2013. So that means it was a recent development. It was actually developed 8 years ago. So we enjoy these two platforms today, MetaTrader 4 and MetaTrader 5. What do you do exactly on MetaTrader 4 and 5? Like I said previously, there are two ways of entering the forex market. There are two ways of entering the forex market. You use market execution and you use pending order. I repeat, you use market execution and you use pending order. Market execution is a type of execution when a client is placing an order and specifies both volume and price. Now, I don't want to go into much of theory today. I just want to be very brief about what I'm saying. Market execution is like, I enter the market directly without a pending order. For instance, I want to go to the market to purchase an item. I bump into the market. That is market execution. Pending order, this is actually when you predict that you enter the market very soon. For instance, I can predict that I will enter the market tonight as at 9 p.m. So that is what a pending order. I make some predictions. Now, pending order is of four types. They are majorly four types. I know in MetaTrader 5, they are up to six, but they are majorly four types. And these four types are the buy stop, sell stop, the buy limit, and what the sell limit. I announced that there will be an advanced class yesterday. In the advanced class, I will dive more into these pending orders, and I'll show you some things. Now, I made a flow chart, or I tried to make a research on flow chart. What exactly is buy stop? Buy stop is when order placed above price and keeps going up. That's a buy stop. Why it sells stock is when order plays below price and keeps going down. A buy limit is when order is placed below price and price then goes up. A sell limit is when order price or order is placed above price and price then goes down. I'll make a deep analysis on all of this in the advanced class. Are you ready? Now, class, let us quickly go into the main business of the day. I'll be talking about three main things, and they are partial closing, partial closing, I'll talk about trade stopping, I'll talk about trade stopping. Then if time permits, I'll talk about swing trading. I wish and I pray that the time permits, I'll talk about swing trading. Now, after all this, we'll now quickly do a practical walk. Madam Ogochukwu, welcome. We are a bit late today. We'll do a practical walk. Let me quickly start with partial closing. What exactly is partial closing? Let's say you have a trade on MetaTrader 4. This is your MetaTrader 4. You know, on MetaTrader 4, there is a region where we have lot size. And let's say the lot size is 0.05. Let's say at the moment I have a trade running. And that trade is what? Euro AUD. Let's say at this point, Mr. Mark is making a profit of $20 on this currency pair. So what's partial closing? Partial closing is when Mr. Mark feels that, if I don't close, take part of this profit, there's every tendency that this market might reverse and I might lose the money totally. What would the man do? The man will come here and he will modify, he will go to you, hold the trade. Once he holds the trade, he will now click on modify. Then he'll go to his lot size. He will edit his lot size. Let's say the man will edit his lot size to what? 0.04. Immediately, this man edits his lot size to 0.04. He will see, notice that underneath something will pop up. Do your mathematics, class. 0.04 lot size out of $20. That is virtually $16. Something will pop up rather. He will see something like close with profit. Close with profit, $16. Class, you know what this means? If Mr. Mark eventually closed this profit, $16, guess what? In his profit margin, it will be registered that he has $16 already. I will show you these things on your phone, don't worry. It will be registered that he has $16 on his profit margin. But guess what? The man still have the opportunity of 0.01 running in the markets. And remember, if you remove 0.04 from 0.05, what will be left? 0.01. This 0.01 will now be left with that $4. Do you know the advantage of this? If eventually this 0.01 hits state profits. Glory be to God. The man will even make an extra profit, probably $7. If this trade, God forbid, hits his stop loss, the man will just have a loss of what? Minus $7. But if, God forbid, the man falls at a loss of $7, it will not be $16 minus $7. That what will be left? $9. At least he still has profit. If this man eventually succeeds in making the $7 previously we wrote, that would be $7 plus $16. What would he be having? He'll be having what? $23. He'll be having $23. So that's partial closing. Partial closing is just a way to book part of your profit in what? In the Forex market. Thank you very much. Let me quickly go to trade stopping. Let's say you have a trade. You know, whenever you are buying in the Forex market, let's say you are still on Euro AUD. Let's say you have a trade running, and this is the entry point. This is a take profit. Thank God I defined take profit and stop loss to you yesterday. And let's say this is stop loss. I want you to know something tonight. When you are buying, if a trade crosses above the entry point, you know, when you are below the entry point, it's having a negative sign, meaning that you are at a loss at that moment. But once it crosses the entry point, you begin to be in profit. Let's say this market goes up and the market started consolidating here. Do you know what consolidation means? Consolidation in Forex market means retracement or pullback. And this consolidation has been persistent such that you are already on $23. If you're already on $23, do you know what trade stopping means? Trade stopping means that, let's say this entry point, you have a value, and the value you have for that entry point is 0.85000. Then let's say you have another value above 0.85 or 0.87. 0.00. Then let's say our stop loss is 0.83. 0.00. Now, what trade stopping means is I want to book part of my profit so that I don't have a total loss in the market. Trade stopping means that I want to book part of my profit so that I don't have a total loss in the market. So what will I do? I will move my stop loss. Let me use a good marker so that you enjoy it. I will move my stop loss above the entry point. If I move my stop loss above this entry point, I can even come here and hook it and put the stop loss here. Plus, you agree with me that if I put, I'm supposed to use a red marker there because the stop loss is a red marker. That's a wine color. If I do that, it means that I have booked. If I do that, it means that I've booked part of my profit here. Then it means if I have 0.8500, then my new value, since I've moved my stop loss, my new value will be what? My new value could be probably 0.86. My new value will be 0.86000. Class, you know what this means? Do you know what trade stopping actually means? It means that if eventually the market doesn't go well, it goes up, it will still come here and swing. It will go and hit my stop loss above my entry point. Are you with me? It means that it will hit my stop loss above my entry point. So if eventually the trade finally hits my stop loss here, you don't have to cry because you have already booked part of your profit, meaning that if it hits here, in your profit margin, you will go home with what? $19. Are you with me? You will still go home with what? $19. So that is trail stopping. I'm sorry, I can't take to in trading today because of time. I really need to do some practical work so that you guys will understand this fully. So now I want to start the practical work. Mr. Mark, are you convenient now? Because I noticed you were not convenient previously.
I am.
Well done, sir. Now, you do me a favor. And what's the favor? I'm going to make you the host. And you will share me your MetaTrader 4. I'll make you the host. And you share me your MetaTrader 4. So let me make you the host right now. I'm going to make you the host. Then you will share your phone, your screen onto the Zoom platform. Is that clear to you? I will put you through. Don't worry. I'll put you through. Let me make you the host first. So, Mr. Man, by the grace of God, you are the host now.
Hello, boss.
Yes, can you hear me, sir?
I can hear you now. We want to do it. Thank you, I'm back.
Okay. Now, sir, you are the host. Let's start work.
Okay.
Sir, go to where you have Zoom on your phone.
Yeah.
Click on share. You will see share at the bottom of your Zoom app.
Share.
Yes.
Okay.
Have you seen, sir? Now, click on screen, sir. After you click on share, click on screen, sir. Click on screen after I click on share.
Now, what they want to say. When I click on share, I just saw this is for others on screen sharing.
Yes, yes. Continue, sir. Continue. Yes, sir.
Okay. I continue. I'm seeing Microsoft on OneDrive, Google Drive, Box, Photo, Document, Web. It's an option.
Did you not see something like screen there?
Okay, I finish.
Okay, click on screen, sir.
Okay.
Oh, beautiful. Your phone will show very soon. Let's give it some time. Oh, this is wonderful. This is wonderful. By the grace of God, we are seeing Mr. Mark's phone. We are seeing his phone. Mr. Mark, hope you are still there, sir.
Yeah, I'm here.
So, sir, go to MetaTrader 4.
Okay.
So, class, we are going to have a practical session of this. Do me a favor. Hold a trade. Hold a trade. Click. Okay. Can you go back to that? Hold a trade. Click on advanced view mode. Oh, beautiful. I love what I'm saying. The reason why I did this is that I want to be able to see your what they call these things again, your ask price and your bid price and your spread.
Okay.
I wanted to see your ask price and your bid price and your spread. Class, what's a spread? A spread is the difference between the ask price and the bid price. I repeat, a spread is the difference between the ask price and the bid price. Now, Mr. Mark, do me a favor. Can you click on the middle button, the third icon, under?
The third icon, okay.
Yes. No. Click on the first icon again. Now, just give me a minute. Can you use your hand to expand this chart? Expand it again. Expand, go on. Okay, do me a favor, click on the screen. Click on M15. Oh, this is beautiful. Just leave it like that. Just leave it like that. Now, class, if you look at that chart, you will notice that there is a red line and there's a green line, there's a blue line. Yes or no, can see it.
Yeah, finish.
That is what they call the spread. That's what they call the ask price is the red line. You can see they are moving. They are the ones forming the candles. The ask price is a red line. And the blue line that is following up simultaneously is the big price. Are you agree? So the difference between them is called a spread. Mr. Mark, I want you to do a quick eye calculation. Okay. Can you quickly tell me the difference between 87.793 and 87.785? You can see that's the value for the two lines.
Okay.
When I did my mathematics, that is 11. That's 11. Oh, it is shifting. That's almost like 11, right? Do me a favor.
Okay.
Click on the first icon.
The third icon.
Yes, the first icon, the first one, which is quote. Click on it. Now, if you look at under that place, sir, under the currency pair, which is CAD/JPY, you will see something like spread there. Look at under the currency pair, CAD/JPY. Have you seen spread there?
Yeah,
that you can see that the spread there is 8. That is how we get the spread. The calculation from that red line and the blue line, that was how the spread was gotten. Do you get that?
That's the low and the high.
Yes, the blue and the red, the low and the high. God bless you, sir. That was how the spread was calculated. Now, let's say, hello, sir. I want you to use a demo account so that you can enter the market. Do you have a demo account? Okay, use the Octa FX demo. Yeah. It's not going through, Abby. Okay, you know what? Let's start a demo account now. Sir, you know what? Click on the hello, you know what? Go back. It will even be a way to teach a class. Click on the plus icon. Click on open a demo account. Where you have find brokers, type Hugo's Way there. H-U-G-O-S. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Click on it. I've seen it. Hugo's Way Demo 3. Sir, are these your informations?
Yeah.
Now, let us use a deposit of 3,000. Click on deposit. Just 3,000. Now click on create account. Now you can screenshot that detail, sir, in case if you want to log in into your demo account. You can screenshot it. Have you screenshotted it? Good. So you know why we screenshotted? In case if you try to log in and it's not going through. You understand? That's how you can log in into the account. You get so now click on done, sir. Oh, Mr. Mark, this is so beautiful. You are doing well tonight. Well done, sir. Sorry for the stress. I'm so sorry. Yes, sir. Now, sir, click on let us now enter the market and show others how to enter the market and trade in the market. Sir, click on AUDUSD. Oh, hold on. Don't you enter yet. Whenever a MetaTrader 4 account is created, we usually have few currency pairs. We usually have a few currency pairs. Sir, go and click on the plus sign.
On what?
On the plus sign above.
Okay.
Now, you see exotics, futures, indices, stocks, FX crosses, energies, metals, cryptos. You see these cryptocurrency people are running about cryptocurrency, I want to buy cryptocurrency. People trade cryptocurrency in forex. Are you with me? People trade cryptocurrency in forex. Now click on exotics.
Okay.
Now in exotics is a region whereby you have currency pairs that do not contain United States dollar, USD. So click on three things. Tap on three things. Okay, it's okay. Go back, sir. Go to that plus sign. Click on the plus sign.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Click on the plus sign. Click on FS crosses. Yes, sir. Class, FX crosses are those currency pairs that do not have United States dollars. Sir, just be tapping on them. Tap on them. And tap. As you are tapping, it's going to your quotes. Don't worry. Tap on them. Go on. Beautiful, sir. Beautiful. Well done, sir. Now, click on metals. Like you can see, class, we have four types of metals in forex. They are silver, gold, platinum. Are you with me? They are silver, gold, platinum. Click on everything here. I know many of you like to trade gold very well. I know that very well. Because they feel that gold is the one having the money. If you don't have a very good account, if your money is not large in the forex account, you cannot really trade gold successfully. It's good to trade gold when you have good amount of money. Are you with me? Okay. Sir, click on cryptos. Yeah.
Crypto.
Now look at Bitcoin. People are dying for Bitcoin. You see BTC USD, that's Bitcoin. Click on it, sir. Have you clicked on BTC USD? No, see BTC USD there now. Bitcoin versus United States dollars. That's beautiful. Go back, sir. So, class, we have finally chosen the pairs you want. Now, we want to go into the market. Hello, class. I want to say something tonight. You don't have to be a professional for you to understand what I'm doing here. You can come with me and you see, understand all the process I'm going through. Sir, can you scroll down?
Okay. Maybe this is the last point.
That's the last point. Okay, let's pick a currency pair. Let's say the currency pair is NZD card. Click on NZD card.
NZD card.
Okay, click on AUD USD. Okay, you can see. That's our balance. Click on AUD USD.
AUD USD, okay.
That's our... No. Do me a favor. Click out.
Okay.
Click out. Click on the third icon, sir. Class, you can see balance, equity, free margin. Whenever you deposit money into your forex account, these are the first set of things you will see. Now, when we pick a trade, two other things will be added. Sir, go back to quotes.
No, okay.
Click on AUDUS. Now, once you click on AUDUS, you see four things. New order, Opal chart, simple properties, and simple view mode. Now, I did not use any strategy to pick this trade. So I will just pick the trade directly. Let's just talk about it. Now, click on new order. Now, I taught you guys lot size yesterday. I said lot size is the amount of money, what you have in your balance divided by 10,000. Did you watch yesterday's video, Mr. Mark? Did you watch yesterday's video?
No, I didn't. I didn't. But I'll go through it.
Okay. So now, you now say 3,000 divided by 10,000. That's 0.3. So here you have 0.01. Right? Type 0.03 there. Type 0.3 there, rather. Type 0.3. No, 0.3. 0.30. Go back, you're out, sir. Type 0.30. That's good. Okay, leave it like that. No wala. Leave it like that. Now, you said you see class, like I said, you either buy or you sell. Let's say you want to buy. Click on buy, sir. You can see order is open. Order is open. Class, can you help me swipe that enough, Mr. Mark? Class, remember when we add this account, we add balance, equity, free margin. I told you that two other things will be added. What are those two other things? Your margin level percent and your margin. Let me define everything. Your balance is what you put into the market. Your equity is your balance minus your open position. What is your open position? Your open position is the minus 1.24. Are you with me, sir? Your open position is your what? Minus 1.24. Now, what's your free margin? Your free margin is what tells you that you can pick. You can see you are in profit already. Whenever you are in profit, it will show blue. If you are in loss, it will show what? Red. Your free margin is what tells you if you are entitled to pick more trade. If, for instance, class, your free margin is 25, you will not be able to pick that trade. Your margin level percent tells you how LD your trade is. What I'm saying is English language, right? Now, class, if your margin level is your margin level percent, if it is less than 100, your account can burn anytime. I repeat, if your margin level percent, you know, right now your margin level percent is 6,573.22. If your margin level percent is less than 100, your account can burn anytime. Then the margin, which is 45.62, you have no business with that. That is for the brokers. Now, class, let me now talk about this currency pair. Class, if you look at it, on that currency pair, there are two values. 0.73582, 0.73577. Let's say the value you have under AUDUSD, which is 0.73582. That is the entry point. Do you know why that thing is showing minus 2.79? That shows that the value you have under that value, which is 0.73573, if that value, which is 0.73573, once it reaches 0.73582, that's minus 2.79 will turn blue. And if it goes above, you start making profits. Mr. Mark, can you tap on that thing once? Click, tap on it once. Just tap on that currency pair once. Class, look at it under. You see something like take profits. You see something like stop loss. Now, quickly, take profit is a point. I define take profit to you, whereby the market reaches and it closes automatically in profits. Stop loss is a point whereby the market reaches and closes in loss. So look at it. The entry point is 0.73582, right? The entry point is 0.73582. Now, take note of that. That's your entry point. Now, to add 10 pips to Mr. Mark. If I add 10 pips to it, what would be the value?
10 pips to it.
Yes, what would be the value?
It would be, well,
it would be 0.736. Miss yeah. Madam Estil, we did this practical yesterday. Now, add 10 pips to it, Madam Estil. Unmute yourself and tell me what will it be, Madam Estil. We did this yesterday. Please, quickly, because of time.
It will be 0.735682.
Yeah? Madam Estee. I will charge you 5,000 naira for that. I will charge you 5,000 naira for that. Oh, no, that's not correct. Mr. Mark, can you go back to it?
Yeah.
Okay, let me now tell you. 10 pips will be 0.73682. You add the 10 to the 5 and 8 now. We did this yesterday.
Yes, that's what I said.
That's what you said.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Wait, I'm so sorry about it.
Wait, sir. You add the 10 to the 5
and 8. Yes.
Yeah, not the 2.
Not the 2. Like, that 2 is meant for the brokers, not for you.
Okay.
That is the pipette. That is the pipette. Okay. Are you with me? If you watch yesterday's class, you will see when I did it. You add that 10 to 5 and 8. So, what will you do now, Mr. Mark? Hold that trade. Hold that trade, Mr. Mark. Go to modify. We have 10 more minutes to go. 10 more minutes. Now type 0.73682, where you have the green line. You notice there are two lines, sir, under the zeros, the red line and the green line. Are you with me? Now write, for the green line, write 0.73682. Quickly, Mr. Mark.
What are you doing? The second one.
The second one, where you have the green line under the zeros. No, the second one, that's the stop loss. That's the stop loss. The second one, 0.73682. Type it, 0.73682. Now, class, let me say something quickly. Assuming that calculation was wrong, you see the modify under, it wouldn't have been alighted. Yeah. You can see modify is alighted, right?
Yeah.
Now, go to your stop loss, sir. For stop loss, let's not bother about stop loss because of time. Type 0.7000 under the red line. 0.7.
Wow.
And leave it like that. Modify is alighted. See, class, whenever you are putting your values for, okay, oh, the man has entered the market. Thank you. He has entered the market. So now click on that trade once. If you look at it, sir, where you have TP, you have 0.373682, right? Where you have SL, you have 0.7000. And you see something like ID transaction. ID transaction is the transaction you made on MetaTrader 4. It's just like when you go to the bank, you deposit money. There's something like teller number. That's what ID transaction is. Commission is for the brokers. The brokers are the ones enjoying that one. They've already charged a commission of -1.55. But don't worry. If you open a live account through me and you run the advanced class program, I will tell you how to survive this commission. And I will tell you the best method to use to open that account. So, Mr. Mark, by the grace of God, I think I have imparted something great into you people today.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome. So now stop sharing your screen. Stop sharing. Click on stop sharing. Thank you. Let me reclaim my host. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. So, class, that is that. Yes, they announced that the advanced class is exactly how much? 10,000 naira. And I told you that the advanced class will start from Monday, which is 26th of July. And it will end on Monday, 9th of August. The advanced class goes for 2 weeks. It starts on Monday, 26th of July, and it ends August 9th. And what time is the advanced class? The advanced class will be starting from 9 p.m. Class, if you want to enjoy more of this, please key into the advanced class. In the advanced class, we'll break it down to pieces. I mean, 2 weeks is not a joke. 2 weeks is not 4 days. This program we are talking about will end tomorrow. all things you are doing will end tomorrow. So the advanced class will now start from Monday. So thank you very much. Please, is there any question before I go? Maybe Madam ST has a question. Mr. Mark has a question. You can ask your question to us. Is there any question? Okay, Madam Okochukwu asked, what is the importance of spread? How do you get margin level? Spread is actually where the brokers they enjoy their money from. Are you with me? Spread is actually where the brokers enjoy their money from. The brokers, they don't have any business with you. Once you put your money into Forex, they will enjoy the money from spread. Are you with me? And like I said yesterday, spread works in two ways. Spread is always tight in the morning, daytime, at night. If you think it's a lie, Mr. Mark, go and check that trade. In the night, around 12, that thing will expand. So whenever it expands, it is expanded because the brokers knows that there are few people trading at night. So for them to make their money, they have to expand the spread. Are you with me? So spread is where brokers make their money from. And I'll teach you deeper things about spread in the advanced class. Because this time is almost gone. I'll teach you deeper things about spread. Now, you said, what is margin level? There are two margin levels I showed you. There's margin level percent and there's margin level. Margin level is meant for the brokers. Margin level is more or less like, I pick a trade. I have my margin accumulated. Are you with me? Margin level is exactly where you pick your trade. Why the margin level percent is, margin level percent shows you how healthy your trade is. If you have a life account here, you can testify to what I'm saying. If your margin level percent is less than 100, your account can burn anytime. How can your account burn? If you have 5 trades, you will see them disappearing one by one. Are you with me? So that's margin level percent and margin level for you and spread. Is there any other question again? Madam Esty, ask your question. Ask your question. You asked it by first question today. Oh, yeah, ask your question. Hello, is there any other question in the house? Mr. Mark.
I'm trying to open the account to open now with my MetaTrade. I can't open it.
Okay, you can't open it. Okay, let me promise you on something tonight. I will send a screen recorder to the group. I will try to set that up tonight. Once I prepare it tonight, I will send it to you so that I can open it successfully.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're welcome. You know, you can't do it like that successfully because it's an online class. But I will send a screen recorder to the group. I was even supposed to do that previously. Are you with me? I will do that to the group, how to set up MetaTrader 4 and how to pick trade. I will do that and so that you can watch it on your on that place.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome, man. Now, someone asks, must you add PIP to your trade? Please send the PDF, Madam Ogochukwu. You like PDF. Let's say the truth. But I like what you are doing. You want to be sure that you're updated. Hmm? Yes. The reason why we add PIPs to our trade, it's not compulsory you add PIPs to your trade. But do you know why we add PIPs to our trade? We add PIPs to our trade so that we can get to a point and leave the market. Sometimes that's a mistake some traders make. You can enter a trade without PIP and stop loss. The thing will be in profit. You'll be smiling. I'm in profit. What will happen the next minute? The thing will reverse. And you just see yourself in loss. Your smile will turn to what? Frowning. Are you with me? So it's better to set a take profit so that you can exit the market. You can get your money in profit and you leave. Are you with me? Thank you very much. Any other question before I go? Just one more question before I go. All right. If there's no question, thank you very much. Don't forget that the advanced class starts from Monday. Your payment can start rolling. There's no problem. Once you make payment, like I said, send a screenshot. Are you with me? Thank you very much. Class, tomorrow will be the last day of the class. Please, let us try to come very quickly because we will be talking more about fundamental analysis and how to manage your trade, part two. I'll teach you how to manage your trade. You know, what I did today was trade management on the theoretical part. I need to talk about, show you on some sites. Are you with me? I need to show you how to manage your trades on some sites. Thank you very much, class. God bless you all. I promise to drop the PDF to you tonight. you will surely get the PDF. You are all wonderful. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome, man. Please do yourself a favor by joining the advanced class. It's a big advice. Do yourself a favor by joining the advanced class. If you join the advanced class, you know. Yes, Madam Ogochukwu, quickly.
The money is too much.
No.
Oh,
Madam, let me tell you the truth. If you check other Forex training institutes, God knows, nobody will charge that for 2 weeks. Go and make your research. In fact, I've not seen anybody that will charge. Mostly they will say 40,000. Go and make your research. Nobody will charge that for 2 weeks. And God is watching my heart. Are you with me? And besides, it's an effort I'm going to put into it. For 2 weeks, we'll be online for 2 weeks learning. Are you with me? Thank you. Yeah.
Hey, Jesus.
Thank you very
much. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're welcome. This time is about to last. Yeah, no problem.
Please, can somebody pay instrumentally?
You can pay instrumentally, but just make sure before the second week.
Before the crowd, we pay the money five.
Yes, exactly. You can pay instrumentally. Yeah. Mr. Mark, Andy, what's the link I'll be dropping? You came very, very